it's an independently elected position. But on top of that, my track record demonstrates that I would govern that office as an independent person. My career has been marked with independence, regardless of who the governor is, regardless of what party is in political power. Just this last year, I led the effort to have the ratepayers of Central Vermont Public Service Corporation refunded their $21 million. I was at odds with the governor and his administration, but nonetheless felt that that was the right decision and led the effort. Velco, the state's only transmission grid, I wanted public representation on that board, and although I didn't get 51%, I got 38 or 39%. Again, pushed the administration and the governor to do what was right by Vermonters and not simply sit back and join the go-along-to-get-along club, which some people tend to do when they're in positions of auditor and other lower-tier positions in state government.
Well, obviously there are opportunities to work with the administration and the legislature, but the auditor indeed has to be truly independent. You know, the legislature often asks the auditor to do certain work for them in anticipation of further discussions about an issue or a department or agency the subsequent year. Really, all you can do is the best job you can. And there's a great staff in the auditor's office. I think they can be better managed, but there's great people there. The quality of the work will speak for itself, and if we do good work, the legislature will be happy. I want to add value to the process.